time for them to make a transition. Because you see, we cannot, and bear with me, I'm just going to talk to you. We cannot sit in the same position and expect a different result. We have to have some kind of a movement. So the Lord bid them push the boat from where it was stationed, from where they left it. How many times we find ourselves at a place we know we have toiled. We remember yesterday's prayer. We remember last week fasting. But I'm at this place now and I cannot move forward. I can't move backward. I can't move sideways. So I decided to just pack it up and sit. If I even finish it on the preacher, I'm going to sit on the preacher today. Because I didn't like what the preacher said. I didn't like the testimony yesterday. So I'm going to sit on the shoreline. And then when I see the preacher coming, I pick up my bag and thought, I'm righteous. Like I was looking at the word. But what he didn't say was what was in the heart. I was sitting on the shoreline, just watching and looking around. Because I lost interest. Because I toiled all night. And I caught nothing. Nobody paid me any attention. I was out there all night.
All night.
If you think about, actually I'm pulling myself back a little bit, getting a little excited. Pull myself back a little bit. If you look at when the Lord says, launch out into the deep. He bid them change the position of the boat. And you see, with the word of God, you have to get an imagination of what's going on. Then they pushed the boat a little further away from where it was. And then the Lord went on the boat and he began to teach. Here comes excuses. The expert fisherman. We have toiled all night. And we have caught nothing. Now, if you are an expert and you have caught nothing, what do you want me to do? What am I going to do? If you are the professional and you are telling me I have toiled all night, I caught nothing. And you're sitting now mending your net. So you expect that the others who are not an expert are going to be watching what you are doing. And they're right behind you mending their net. So what we have in front of fishermen, we have net menders. Bless the name of Jesus. So now people are just sitting by mending net. What good is the net? What good is the net? Hallelujah to God. Saint of the living God. Sit on the Lord God, get me excited. Bless the name of Jesus. If you look in your mind, the net is being mended. What's the purpose? What's the purpose? You just told me you toiled all night. And you've caught nothing. So, the only thing is left to do now is to sit down and put the net together and wash it and get it clean. Saint of the living God. After a little while, when the net is dry, it's going to get rotten. is going to get rocky.
Holy Ghost.
The net is made with a kind of a fiber that survive in water. It is not to be mended and put aside. Bless the name of Jesus. You've got to make sure at all times that the net is in water. It survived in water. Bless the name of Jesus. And it must be used to catch fish. What's the purpose of the net without fish? Hallelujah to God. What's the purpose of a fisherman if you're not fishing? What's the use? Let's just look quickly at the scriptures. We're going to just look at the scripture one more time. Let's go to St. Luke 5. I'm not going to be too long. Promise you that. Glory to God. Bless the name of Jesus. The Bible says, when elect speak it, after he spoke with them. Verse 4, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down. If you notice that every time the Lord came on the scene, he had a purpose.
Amen.
The problem with leaving the shoreline is to make sure of the purpose.
Oh, God.
If there is no purpose, we're going to sit on the shoreline.
Yes.
And what we have today, saints of the living God, if God's people get up from the shoreline,
holy God,
pick up your net. Hallelujah to God. By faith, step out and throw your net out into the deep. You can't just get up and pick up the net. No good. No good. You gotta throw it into the sea. And you can't just throw it anywhere. You gotta throw it into the deep. You know, something just come in my spirit. You see that news that we got a couple days ago with that little boy in Florida that was eaten by the crocodile? If you think about that for a moment, that crocodile was there watching.
Yes.
In the water. Maybe nobody else was thinking that something else could be in the water.
In the shallow.
But the crocodile was not out in the deep.
No, it was in the shallow.
It was right there on shore.
Yes.
And if somebody had paid attention, they would have seen something. Let me tell you that. Because that crocodile didn't go into the deep.
No.
It was right there where you could see the shadow of the back. Under the water, it doesn't matter how dark that water gets.
Yes.
You can see movement.
Amen.
That's what we allow the enemy to do to us.
Yes.
We sit by idle. We sit by under the covering of Christianity.
Yes.
We sit by under the covering of the long dress.
Yes.
We sit by under the covering of the natural ear.
Yes.
And we allow the enemy, like the crocodile,
yes,
to creep up.
Yes,
while we sit there and mend our nets.
Yes.
Bless the name of Jesus. But I came back to ask you today, what are you doing with the net? And do you know where your net is? Do you know where your net is? You know where your net is? Tell mama don't even know where we fold it up and put it. Fold up the net and put it somewhere. Because we're not interested anymore. We have lost interest. It's not about Jesus anymore. It's about brother. It's about sister. It's about pastor. It's about me not giving them an offering no more. It's about I'm not doing this, I'm not doing that. We have talked about our nets.
Amen, amen.
And we have no idea where our nets are. So even if the Lord should say, launch out into the deep. By the time we come back looking for net bishop, some of us will be lost.
Yeah.
Like the virgins. We go out good. But we forget that we need oil. We need resource. We need the power of God. We need an anointing. But you cannot get it with a broken neck or a dried up neck. Bless the name of Jesus. You can't launch out into the deep. Neither can I. Except we are totally separated, totally changed our position. Bless the name of Jesus. We need a new mindset, apostolic people. We need a new vision, apostolic people. We need a turnaround. I wish you would all just jump up and turn around. We need a turnaround. Change the position. Switch to the other side. Bless the name of Jesus. Some of us need to turn around a few times. We have lost our focus. We have lost our place with God. We have lost our prayer life. We have lost our fasting life. All we want is recognition. But what we need is to launch out into, you know, last week I was in Florida and I had a service to attend. And I just felt like going on the street. I'm a little off sometimes, evangelist. I got in my car, I rented a car, and I left my sister in the hotel room and I just began to drive down the street on the 95, the Highway 7 in Florida. And I couldn't understand why I was doing that. After about maybe 5 miles or so, I turned around to come back toward the hotel. And as I turned around, I looked in the sky. And I saw, a part of a cloud. It was as black as midnight. I have never seen cloud like that. It was black. Since I looked up, as I was driving, and I said, Lord have mercy. And I heard something speak to my mind. Florida is in trouble.
Amen.
There is doom and gloom over this place.
Yes.
One of the young men that I raised lived in Florida. He was coming to see us at the hotel. And he came by, and I was in the car in the parking lot when he came. So he saw me and he came and he sat with me in the car. And we were there talking for a few minutes, and he said, Mommy, were you in the parking lot by yourself? And I said, I don't know. I just felt like being out here. And he said, I said to him, well, I don't know, but it just seemed like there's doom and gloom over Florida.
Amen. Amen.
And he said to me, Mommy, nah, it's just hurricane season. I said, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about there is doom and gloom over the city.
Jesus.
And I went on to tell him, I said, you all got to pray.
Amen.
I said, we are in trouble.
Yes.
This land is in trouble.
Amen.
Saints, we are in trouble.
Yes.
Our souls are in trouble with God.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Sin has taken over the very assembly.
Yes.
We are in trouble with God.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
You don't even know where the saints know to become ain'ts. Bless the name of Jesus. My God Almighty, no longer we can talk about sin. People get offended when you tell them about sin. But sin is still wrong. Sin is still going to take you out of the burning head. Sin will still lead us into hell. Bless the name of Jesus. Glory to God. So I said, no.
My God.
Something not good. Saints, I left the service. Got to the hotel about 1:30 on Saturday night, this past Saturday night. And when we got there, I said, it's not even time to go to sleep. I got to be at the airport by 7 a.m. to get back for service on Sunday. So what I did, I started packing. Not knowing that an hour later, that bloodbath was in the same city. Right there in Florida. Bless the name of Jesus. While the church of God sit by, instead of loving one another, instead of building up one another, things that are loving and making sure that the saints are not in want and need. And we pray for one another. My God, and lift up the hand. We said our elder demonstrated something that I, oh my God. She was the person that they used. Come here, evangelist. I'm going to borrow our elders. Stand right here. This is the church. This is the church. And sometimes you notice the church has hand and feet and head and everything. But sometimes the hand get tired. Hold the hand up. And our elder demonstrated this recently. The hand is being held up. And the hand get tired. And what do we do? What do we do? We are out into the deep, you know. We have launched out into the deep. And we come in church and we shout. But look at this hand. She's been holding it for a while. Amen. But she's holding it for a while. After a while, what's going to happen? You sure? She's going to get tired. What does the church do? What does the apostolic church do? Instead of launching out into the deep. What do we do? Come and come and show them what we do. Bless the name of Jesus. There is something that we are missing, saints. The hand is what?
Held up.
And what happened? Is it going to get tired still?
No.
You don't think it will get tired? It will still get come here. Hold my hand. We are launching out. We are going to the deep. Amen? This is our demonstration by our elder recently. You're holding the what? The hand. It's easier for her, for the church to stand. Because the church has help. Come, Bishop. Bless the name of Jesus. We're looking at the church. We want to launch out. Hold the hand, Bishop. What's going on? We're holding the hand. So the church is getting stronger. The church is getting stronger. Come on, Ella. Ella Robinson, come on. Hold the hand. I call you Robinson. Yo, you come. Jackson, come on, Ella Jackson. Hold the hand. What happened to the church? We are launching where? Out into the what? Into the what? So the more strength we have into the deeper happen. And the stronger we become. And the stronger we become. So when the Lord said, launch out. Come here, evangelist. Bless the name of Jesus. Even though the hand is getting tired. What's going on here, saints? And what happened to the hand that is tired? It's getting what? The church needs to gain strength. The church needs strength. Give me some volume on the mic. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We need strength, people of God. The hand, the church is getting tired. Bless the name of Jesus. The people of God are getting tired. Bless the name of Jesus. I need some more people. I need some more arm of you. Come, missionary. Come on, missionary club. I think that's the name. Come on, hold the hand. Come on, people of God. I want you to see today. We are going to be a launch here. Where are we going? Into the what? Into the what? We're holding the hand. You think you're feeling tiredness? Why not? Because the church is behind the people of God. You're holding the hand. Come on, somebody. Come on, see, don't be distracted, people of God. Don't be distracted. Push away in your mind from the shoreline. Somebody begin to push. Look at the shoreline. Look where you are. And begin to push. I want 5 people to start pushing. Start pushing. Start pushing from the shoreline. You're going to go into the deep. You're going to launch out. Because we have strength. Somebody stand on your feet. And give God some glory for strength. And give some more strength. Come, evangelist. Almaranga, come. We need more strength. We need reinforcement. We're going to keep the net. out into the deep. We are going for a great catch. Hallelujah. We want a great catch. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. When was the last time you held up somebody's hand? When was the last time you strengthened somebody? Launch out. Somebody launch out into the deep. We are not that important. It's about Jesus. You're not that important. It's about Jesus. Launch out. Push out from the shoreline. Hold up the hand. God Almighty. I wish you would find somebody. Turn around. Begin to help somebody. Turn around and hold up somebody's hand. Glory to God. Come on, minister to somebody. Tell them you're pushing from the shoreline. You're pushing. You're going to launch out. Now when you launch out into the deep, and when you get there, drop your net. Drop your net. Drop your net for the catch. Because if you don't go to the deep, you can't catch. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Glory.
People of God. It is time the church move from the shoreline. It is time the church drop your net. It is not just a scripture. It is not just for talk. It is the whole. It's a command from the Lord. Launch out into the deep and drop your net. Don't go out there without your net. Don't sit on the wayside. Idle men in your net. Idle men while fishing go cold. Don't sit by while the church of God being destroyed. Praise the Lord. Don't sit by while the saints are dying. Don't sit by while souls are perishing. Hold up the hand. Hold up the hand of your brethren. Hold up the hand of your leaders. Bless the name of Jesus. We waste too much time. We waste too much time worrying about what we can't change. We waste too much time talking about our faults and failures. The Lord knew we were going to fail. He knew we were going to fail when He gave us the Holy Ghost. He knew that. My God, spend that time helping one another to move from the shoreline forward forever. And don't look back, saints of God. Saints of God is not looking back time. I wish above all that you prosper and be in good health as your soul prosper. But if your soul not prosper, your health won't prosper. Glory to God. If you refuse to all of the end of God's people. Hallelujah to God. I promise I didn't want to make you upset. But it doesn't make sense that we waste our time and this thing become a ritual. We just come to impress. And we come for somebody to say she was in church or he was in church. But when we were coming, we left Jesus somewhere. And it has taken days to figure out where we leave him. And the trouble is some of us don't know where we have left him. So we can't go back and find him. The scripture said he was drowning with his parents. And the Bible said he stopped to go about his father's business. And his mother and his father went on as though he was still there. And it was days later, oh glory to God, that they discovered that he was missing. Samson did the same thing. He thought like at other times, I will go out, and I will do wild, I will do thee, and I will have the strength. But some of us have lost that strength long time ago, we don't know where we left it. Because we have sat on the shoreline for too long. Bless the name of Jesus. But I just came back to remind you today. Pick up your net. Pick up your net. Hallelujah. And head for the deep. And when you get there, don't just stand and look. Throw in your net. Throw in your net. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and tell them, throw your net in. Let it down deep. Oh, glory to God. So you can get some substance. Substance is not on the surface. There's nothing too good on the surface. It's only what you can see. Are your hands feel this? She feels tired. Can I get some more help? Can I get another help? Somebody run up here and come give her help. The hand is still tired. Come on. Look at God's people. Glory to God. Glory to God. There should be all in the hand. Everybody should be all in the hand. She shouldn't be feeling any pain. She should not be discomforted. She should not be uncomfortable. Because we love one another. We all in one another's hand. My God. My God. My God. It's time the church of God stand up to the word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't be just content to talk about yesterday's victory. Yesterday's gone. You need today's victory. You need today's victory. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. You know, tomorrow is not even promised. Today is special. Today is special. I just want to ask if there anybody. God bless you, people of God. Hallelujah. Is there anybody in this house who is willing to leave the shoreline? Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not to have the latest anything. It's not you trying to outdo me. It's not you trying to outdo anybody. Is how you gonna apply yourself in the deep.
Hallelujah.
Launch out. Change your position. Change your mindset. Change your attitude. God Almighty, the church of God is filled with so much attitude where people are dying. Souls are dying. My God. My God. We are just full of ourselves in the apostolic church. It's all about me and I. My God, while the people are dying in sin. I know you need to go and eat. I see them making sin. Praise the Lord Jesus. But I'm calling your conscious minds today. I'm calling your conscious minds today. To the place where God wants us to be. And is not on the shoreline. So when he speaks, his voice makes the difference. Whenever God speaks, you know it. You should know the difference. You know, when God speaks, you don't forget. If God speaks to you about something in your own life, you never forget. Every day it is fresh in your mind. Every day you remember it. It doesn't matter what anybody says. Remember the pastor who said, the lady was on her knees at the altar praying. He said, maybe she's drunk.
Yes.
Yes.
It was pastor said it.
God.
And all Anna was doing was seeking God.
Yes.
But the pastor came to a conclusion. Yes. I don't know if he was not out into the deep. Oh, maybe he was at the shoreline.
Yes.
But she was heading for the deep.
Yes.
And he thought she was drunk. Yes. Just the name of Jesus. Because somebody may think you're drunk. But you must tell them, you are not drunk as you suppose.
Yeah.
But I'm heading for the deep.
Yeah.
And you can't go to the deep.
Yeah. Oh, Lord.
If you're not equipped.
Yes.
You must have the right equipment.
Yes.
Just imagine me trying to swim.
Yes.
I'm not going to attempt to swim. Because I'm not a swimmer.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
But if I could swim, I would probably head for the deep.
Yes.
But I'm not going out there because I can't do it. But some of us want to go out there. I'm going to say one more thing. I'm going to take my seat. I remember somebody told us a story a couple of years ago at one of our conferences that we had to go. And he said there was a young man that came into his church. And he said the young man wanted to preach right away. And so he came and he started saying things as the preacher would preach. He would try to override the preacher. And so he said, you know, brother, you want to preach? Come on up. He took his Bible and he went up. And Bishop, I heard that he said, there was a man that went down from Jerusalem to Jericho. And he fell among thorns. And the fragment was 12 baskets. So somebody asked him, where you find the scripture? He couldn't tell them where the scripture was found. Because that's not in our Bible. And maybe you don't get it. But that's not in our Bible. What we need to do is to develop that kind of faith and integrity.
Amen.
To stay where God has put us. And do what God has equipped us to do.
Yes.
If God equipped you to be a fisherman, go out here and fish. Bless the name of Jesus. You can't be a dentist if you're a fisherman. You know, many times people have said things that, oh, she's just so quiet. I'm not very quiet. I'm quiet, but I'm not very quiet. Because while they're making noise, I'm learning how to lean on Jesus. I'm learning how to live. Bless the name of Jesus. I'm studying how to get into the deep. Ah, glory to God. And if you stay there for a while and use the word of God to help your mind and study how to from the shoreline.
Bless our Lord.
You got to have a catch.